Yo, my vida, boss little. Call me when you're feeling sick. Call me when you're feeling down.
Hey loves, it's Adanna here and welcome back to my channel. So I'm just going to start off this video by apologizing for my absence. Your girl has just been, I don't even know. I took a mini break that low-key turned into a semi-break. But today, y'all, I was feeling very energized, very revived. And I was like, you know what? I'm going to fix up my hair, you know, wash my hair, get myself together and all of that juicy stuff while taking it all along. Starting off with washing my natural hair, y'all, I just took down my passion twist hairstyle. I kept that on for 2 weeks and I just wanted a deep cleansing of my scalp. Normally when I want to deep cleanse my scalp, I normally use my apple cider vinegar shampoo, but y'all, I completely ran out of my apple cider vinegar shampoo. So what I decided to do was start off using my Kaleidoscope moisture silk shampoo. I love the fact that this shampoo actually hydrates your hair and doesn't strip your hair of moisture, which is just fantastic. However, because I wanted to do like a deep cleanse of my scalp today, I went ahead to do an apple cider vinegar rinse, like you guys can see. So for my apple cider vinegar rinse, I just had half and half. So half water and then half apple cider, like on, or is it unfiltered? On, yo, English is hard today for me. So I'm using the raw one just so I could get all the benefits and all the juiciness that apple cider vinegar brings for your hair. If y'all didn't know, aside from like deep cleansing your scalp, there are so many benefits that apple cider brings to your hair, especially if you have dandruff, flaky scalp. It always helps. Also keeps your natural hair shiny, moisturized. It's so much easier to detangle because your hair becomes so soft. In fact, there are just so many benefits of apple cider vinegar rinse. So right now I'm done washing my hair, I'm just going to go ahead to move on to deep conditioning. So for deep conditioning, I'm going to be using this Maui moisture shea butter hair mask. Yo, so this is my first time actually trying this particular deep conditioner. It was sent to me and I decided to give it a shot. I love the fact that it contains shea butter because it is so moisturizing. However, I wish it had a little bit more slip for detangling my natural hair, because as you guys can see, the middle of my natural hair is more kinky than the rest of my hair. It's quite interesting, but the middle of my natural hair is just it's like it doesn't even want to move at all. So yeah, so I just kept on repeating this entire deep conditioning using this hair mask all over my hair in sections, and I ended up with 5 sections. So 2 in front, 1 in the middle, and 2 at the back. After I was done deep conditioning my hair, detangling it and putting them in this chunky twist, I just went ahead to wear my shower cap on top of my hair just so I can allow this deep conditioner to, you know, to work and sieve into my hair. And if you want that little bit of extraness, that little bit of boost of oomph, you can go ahead to use a heating cap. I got mine off of Amazon, the heating cap that I'm using. However, if you don't have a heating cap, just a shower cap is perfectly fine as well. You get enough heat that will allow all of this product to just work and take place and do its thing inside there. Okay, so I left this on for 40 minutes. This is literally my favorite part of wash day, when I'm just done deep conditioning and my hair just feels so soft. It just feels so good. So I rinsed off the deep conditioner and I just went ahead to tie my t-shirt to dry my hair. And then right now I'm just going to go ahead to move on to moisturizing my hair, and I'll be using the Mielle Organics Honey and Pomegranate Leave-In Conditioner. And then to seal all of this moisture, I'm using my Jamaican Black Castor Oil from I Am Pure. And then once I'm done with all the moisturizing and sealing of moisture, I'm just going to go ahead right now to prep my natural hair for this headband wig that I'm going to be putting on. I'm going to put in my hair in 4 chunky cornrows all the way to the back. Those lazy girl kind of cornrows. So you just do 4 big ones just so your hair stays flat under this wig. That's exactly what's going to be happening today. So I'm going to go ahead to put this in 4 chunky cornrows. Speaking of cornrows, I also wanted to show you guys how you could prep your natural hair for your headband wig. Personally, I don't really like when I have my the lines of my cornrows showing in front of my headband wig. I don't know if that makes sense. I normally do like the front of my headband wig to look like my natural hair is slick back and a ponytail under the wig cap. So normally if I want to do cornrows under my wig cap for this headband wig, I try to make sure that the cornrows are in a little bit backwards. So like this one, for example, I'm not going to start the cornrows from the very, very, very front. I made sure that the cornrows are backwards, more so just so my natural hair is sleek in front. And when I wear the headband wig and I'm showing off my edges, you wouldn't be seeing the lines of the cornrows. But if you start your cornrows from the beginning, you'll most likely be seeing the lines of your cornrows. And sometimes you could even see your cornrows in front of your headband wig. I mean, this is up for personal preference, but I do like my headband wig to look very natural, like everything is together. You know what I mean? Exactly. You're back home in Nigeria. Interestingly, when you do your cornrows like this far backwards, we call it brush. So when your cornrows are like starting from a very distant place to be done, we call it brush. On the other hand, if you do have thicker natural hair, feel free to have more than 5 plaits of this cornrows. You can still achieve the entire brush look regardless of the number of cornrows that you do have. Once I was done doing this, my chunky cornrows and having my natural hair all flat and nice, I went ahead to use my Kaleidoscope Miracle Drops and just, you know, oiled my scalp. And then I went ahead to do some edges, you know, fix up the edges real quick and put on my wig cap. For this headband wig, y'all, I'm trying something different. Okay, it's a straight headband wig, but guess what? It's kinky straight headband wig. Yo, this feels so good. It feels so good. I love the texture. It just feels like a natural hair blowout. This headband wig is from Wiggins Hair and is in 24 inches. They also sent me a few beautiful items, a couple headbands, like you guys can see. This little clutch bag. And even what's this thing called? These lashes. That was just like yeah. I guess I'm about to be flying with this because these lashes are like the longest lashes I've come across in my entire life. And there's also a wig cap and an extra elastic strap. So this is what the hair looks like. It comes with 3 combs in front right there, and then 2 combs at the back, and then it also comes with this Velcro that you clap at the back to hold down this wig. Also, shout out to you guys for letting me know that this is called a Velcro. You remember how I was calling this a styrofoam mesh? Can you imagine? So to give your headband wig that extra security, I normally go ahead to use the clips in front to just lock that right there, right under my wig cap, just so it stays in place and it doesn't move at all. And then one thing I found very different about this particular headband wig is the fact that the headband itself was not sewn up to like half the circumference of the wig, if you all know what I mean, compared to the other ones I've tried. What I did was just to make sure that the lines of this wig was properly covered with the headband across the entire circumference of my head. But y'all, I love how long this hair is. I love the fact that this hair was just so easy to apply. I didn't have to wet it. I literally just brought it out straight from the box. Definitely going to be my go-to wig for this winter season. You can straighten it if you want yours to be all straight and sleek and nice. You could also add some curls to this hair if you would like. I just love the texture of this hair, how easy it is to apply. It was just bomb. Okay, moving on to the styling of this hair. Of course, you could style this just by leaving it all down to the back and, you know, you get yourself out the door. But you could also put it in a ponytail like you guys could see me do right now. And to just give that ponytail that extra oomph, you know, that extra spice, you could go ahead to like a bubble ponytail. This look was inspired by Miss Naturally Mary here on YouTube. I love the way this bubble ponytail just looked on her. She was just looking stunning. And to add that extra jollof to this ponytail, I just went ahead to put on this velvet headband that I showed you guys. Oh, I was just looking like a dessert menu. And if you want to be a little bit extra, you could just go ahead and add some accessories, you know, just, you know, put some touch here and there and call it a look. For this next hairstyle, we're going to be doing like a high bun. So I'm just going to go ahead to grab all of this hair and put it in a high ponytail using this, my little scrunchie band. Go through the ponytail to make sure that everything is smooth and then just go ahead to start twisting. So I twisted it all the way to the very end, and then when you get to the very end of your twist, you want to make sure that you're using this little elastic band to hold the twist at the very end, just because if you don't hold the twist at the end, it tends to unravel. So I use the little elastic band to hold that, and then I just wrapped this all around into a nice bun. That's it for this look, y'all. For this one, I'm serving you all like a fall pumpkin spice with this particular headband. You know, this is like your everyday easy look to school, to work, to everywhere. I feel like you just can never go wrong with a high bun. And then for this next look, I'll be doing a half up, half down. I went ahead to put half of my hair in front upwards in a high ponytail. Love the fact that this particular look shows off the texture of this hair and how full it is. It's just so nice. And then you can just go ahead to swirl that top part of your ponytail into a nice bun. And that's basically it for this video, y'all. I hope you'll enjoy this, from the wash day to the styling of this headband wig. I hope you all enjoyed it, and if you did, don't forget to give me a big thumbs up, comment, share, subscribe. Let me know down below in the comment section which of these hairstyles was your favorite one from 1 to 6, and I will see you all in my next one. Love you all so much and have a wonderful rest of your weekend. Bye. Shake it, shake it, make it nasty. Shady clip.